Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us for Living Local, your lifestyle show for all things Charleston and beyond. I'm Ashley Meserve.
It's Medical Monday at East Cooper Medical Center, and today we're visiting the Cardiovascular Transitions Clinic to see how this new state-of-the-art facility promises to improve the overall experience and quality of care for those suffering from a wide range of heart-related conditions.
Medical Monday, sponsored by East Cooper Medical Center.
Joining us today, we have Kelly Guerrero. She is a physician's assistant here at East Cooper Medical. Thank you so much for having us today.
Thank you for coming.
All right, I'm super excited because we're talking about an exciting new thing here. Mm-hmm. It's the Cardiovascular Transitions Clinic.
Yes.
All right, first off, tell us what that is.
So it's new. This is something that East Cooper hasn't had before, and it's a clinic to help bridge the gap in care. So for patients that were just in the emergency room and need to be seen within 24 or 48 hours, or patients that were just discharged from the hospital, or patients that can't see their regular cardiologist, we can help with those patients.
Okay. So what do you do in this
system? Clinic?
Yeah.
So I'm the primary medical provider. So I'm a physician assistant, but as a PA, we work as a member of a team. So I'll be primarily supervised by Dr. Min Tran. He's a board certified cardiologist with Coastal Cardiology. And so he will be overseeing the clinic, but I can also work with each patient's individual cardiologist to develop a plan of care that's best for them.
I gotta tell you this, whenever I go to the doctor, I'm like, can I get a physician's assistant? Because I feel like y'all are always on top of your game.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so what, kind of give us like a scenario though. Mm-hmm. So I'm, because this, is this like a thing that you see at other hospitals, or is this, you know, something y'all are just coming up with?
So other hospitals have heart failure clinics, which are great, but just for patients that have congestive heart failure. This is a little bit more broad and all-encompassing. So if somebody has atrial fibrillation and they need medications titrated, we could see them. If patients have chest pain and they went into the emergency room and it was a low-risk patient, they had blood work and they ruled out a heart attack, we could see those patients and get them in for a stress test in a timely manner. Patients that need to be risk stratified before surgery, we can also see those. And as I mentioned, patients that can't get into their cardiologist because of time constraints of their regular doctor, we can see those patients too.
And are you communicating with their cardiologist?
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
And they're like coming to you as like, they will say, go get a stress test?
Well, their cardiologist could say, you know, I can't see you for, you know, a month. And but instead of going to the emergency room, perhaps you could go see Kelly at the Transitions Clinic. But yes, there will be direct lines of communication with their cardiologist, and they will always go back and see them after they see me.
And talk about kind of what you're looking forward to when it comes to this experience.
I really hope to be a healthcare advocate for these patients. You know, medicine can be confusing, getting plugged into the right doctors can be really hard, and I just hope to be there to advocate for the patients, making sure that they get the follow-up that they need, that they understand their medications, that they understand the disease process that we're dealing with, and just really improve their overall health and well-being.
And is it, I would assume that it's an education process as well, right?
Yes.
Because then you get to spend more time with them.
Correct.
Right?
Correct. And, you know, and a lot of times, you know, we just haven't had the ability to do that. And this physician really offers me more time so I can do a better job at educating patients.
So if I'm sitting at home and I'm thinking to myself, like, I need a stress test and I don't know, I mean, like, do they need to call y'all? Do they need a referral first?
Yes.
Or how does that work?
So they'll need a referral. It's usually best to go through either their primary care physician or their primary cardiologist. But they can call our number directly for the Cardiac Transitions Clinic and get an appointment made through there.
Okay, so they can actually go through a primary care physician. So they don't have to already have gone to
It's better if they already have established with their, you know, with a cardiologist first.
And then, but if they haven't though, y'all can help them kind of
get plugged in.
The right
Right, get plugged into the right cardiologist. Yes,
Perfect.
Ma'am.
All right. Is there anything else we need to know before we head out today? I'm looking behind me. I love when we get cool backgrounds and stuff. This is going to be your area, right?
Right. I think the main thing to know is that East Cooper is developing their cardiology service line, and that the same cardiologists that you can get in other hospitals are here as well. So you can do a lot of the same procedures. So diagnostic heart catheterizations, pacemakers, implantable loop event recorders, stress test echoes, cardioversions, all of those things can be done here at East Cooper as
well. Hey, I tell you, Patrick Downs, He is always making things happen here, isn't he?
He's fantastic.
All right, Kelly. Well, thanks again
for having us. Thank you. It was nice to meet you.
And for more information, you can head online to eastcoopermedctr.com.